The Frankie Debusk Show is a special presentation of the Pioneer Sports Network. The Frankie Debusk Show with head coach Frankie Debusk and the voice of the Pioneers, Brian Stayton.
The Frankie Debusk Show is presented by your Greenville Light and Power System, serving Greenville and Greene County since 1945. Andrew Johnson Bank, a strong heritage, a stronger future. Home-owned and operated with locations in Johnson City, Jonesboro, Morristown, Cleveland, and Greenville. Sodexo, a world leader in food and facilities management services. Creekside Markets, don't pass by, stop by, with three locations in Greene County. Special consideration from Comcast Cable through Xfinity.
And now, the voice of the Pioneers, Brian Stayton.
It's homecoming, it's Hall of Fame, and it's Wingate. Hello, everyone. Welcome back into the Frankie Debusk Show, the Tusculum Pioneers and the Wingate Bulldogs. You know, Wingate rolls into Tusculum's Pioneer Field at the Nyswanger Sports Complex this past weekend as the 23rd-ranked team in the nation, one of 17 teams in Division II that was unbeaten. They would leave that place, however, once beaten. It's a Wingate team that's getting off to a good start. They have the best defense in the nation, and what they're doing is outscoring the opposition in the first half, 72-15, getting out to that big lead. Meanwhile, the Pioneers are struggling out of the gate. In the first quarter, they're being outscored 52-10. This particular day would be Wingate's biggest challenge, however. Their defense is tops. They're only allowing 5.6 points a game. As a matter of fact, they have shut out three opponents on the year going into the contest with Tusculum, who's averaging 32 points per contest. Think about the hard luck Bears, right? The bad news Bears, if you will. This is a Pioneer team. If they didn't have bad luck, they wouldn't have any luck at all the early part of the season. They're 10 points away from being 4-1 on the year and unbeaten in the conference as well. They've got to feel as if they're owed something. 2 weeks ago against Brevard, they figured out how to get a shutout against a conference opponent and how they had a running game in Isaac Robinson, who was the reigning conference offensive player of the week. This particular week, Mark Kolb saw that as a particular challenge with the nation's number one defense coming to town. Now, not only just number one defense, but they do a lot of things right. They hold you to under 200 yards per game. They keep you from getting first downs in a game. All numbers that Tusculum do quite well in the conference as well. Third in the conference in total offensive yards. They are first in the conference in first downs gained this year. Plus a whole lot of other numbers that I won't bore you with. However, it was a huge contrast in styles, offense and defense. And on this day, there was no overtime needed. It was just a pure game. The Pioneers win it, going away by a final score of 26-17. Yeah, more like a typical college football game. Wingate's defense was good, but the Pioneer offense turned out 500 yards of offense, limited Wingate to under 250 yards of total offense on the day as well. There were plenty of numbers to talk about, and we'll talk about those as Isaac Robinson rushed for 195 yards and a touchdown to lead the Pioneers to that win over 23rd-ranked Wingate University, the 23rd-ranked team that had come in. Think about that as well. Tusculum has played 41 opponents, now 42, who have been ranked. They have just 11 wins. They get their first win since 2008 when they beat Carson Newman that year. Pioneers hand the Bulldogs their first loss of the year, and they've improved to 3-3 and 2-2, while Wingate falls to 5-1 and 2-1. For the Pioneers, 45-44 home win against Carson Newman was the last time they had beaten a ranked opponent. The Pioneers racked up 26 points and 511 yards against the number one scoring defense and the number four total defense, which had allowed only 196 per game. The Pioneer defense limited Wingate to 248 yards offensively, including just 82 yards by the league's second leading rusher, Lawrence Pittman. Now, Isaac Robinson established a school single-game record with 250 yards last week at Brevard. He followed that outing with the ninth-best rushing performance in Tusculum history. Robinson averaged 7 yards a carry on his 28 attempts. He also hauled in a 16-yard reception and finished with over 200 all-purpose yards for a second straight week. Meanwhile, Tusculum sophomore quarterback Luke Lancaster passed for 268 yards and 3 touchdowns. He still leads the conference with over 300 yards passing. He has fallen, though, out of the top 20 in passing yards per game in the nation. He also rushed for 16 yards on 4 carries. Senior Justin Houston accounted for a game-high 8 receptions for 44 yards and 2 touchdowns. Defensively, senior linebacker Quez Gaines led the Pioneers in tackling for a second consecutive game. He totaled 9 stops, including 2 behind the line of scrimmage. During that final possession, I want to point out, senior Kenny Funny made his 5th reception of the game. With that catch, he and Justin Houston have tied the NCAA Division II record for the most receptions in a career from 2 receivers from the same team. Houston, who has 270, Funny, who has 147. The Tusculum duo matches the 417 receptions made by fellow NCAA Division II record holders, Rashad Carter and Deontay Gist, from 2008 to 2011. Funny how things work out in a Mark Kolb offense. Funny that duos once again lead the nation. There was also a duo that was crowned homecoming king and queen on this particular day. Homecoming king goes to Indy Torres and our homecoming queen to Miranda Knight. Congratulations to you guys. It was homecoming. There was lots of festivities. The alumni was on town. The board of directors were on town. The president gave the speech about the new building going up on campus as well. A lot of good things to talk about because, well, the Pioneer football team won the game as well. It was awesome. We'll talk about it when we return. Tusculum and Wingate here for the Frankie DeBusk Show.
Your Greenville Light and Power System, an electrical distributor of TVA, serving Greenville and Greene County since 1945. Your Greenville Light and Power is dedicated to excellence in service and reliability. Visit online at glps.net. Sodexo, a world leader in food and facilities management services. Sodexo proudly serves Tusculum College and supports Pioneer football. Sodexo, making every day a better day.
Showtime. You know what it is. Everything we do it big. Screaming, that's not when we step up on the field. That's not small town, but we still do it very big. Black and Norris, black and Norris, black and Norris, black and Norris. We grind hard for the rings with the diamonds on it. Black and Norris, black and Norris, black and Norris, black and Norris.
Welcome back into the Frankie DeBusk Show. The Tusculum Pioneers knock off the 23rd-ranked Wingate Bulldogs this past Saturday in fine fashion for homecoming and in front of the alumni. Joined by Pioneer coach Frankie DeBusk as we get set to take a look at the game itself. Coming in, I think you felt like you had to have a feel-good. And last week, a total running game style, but a defense that has started to come together. So you had to feel good about it going in against the nation's number one defense.
Well, Brian, I talked all week about some things that I thought we needed to do offensively and defensively, and this game was probably as solid a game as we've played in a long time from the offensive side and the defense side of the football. I thought Mark Kolb, our offensive coordinator, did a great job making some big calls in critical situations, and I thought Mike Isaac did a great job once again making some adjustments at halftime and limiting them to what they were able to do. I'm just really proud of how we played. We didn't execute from a special team standpoint like I would like for us to, so don't know that we won that phase, although we did get a big turnover on special teams after giving one up. But really proud of the execution. I thought we had a chance to really play a good football game. I told our team before the game the cards were in line for us to put 4 quarters together from both sides of the ball, and I thought we executed and played well.
You know, it's a Wingate team with Coach Reich, and coming in, they didn't show a whole lot of offense, but their defense obviously was great. You take a look at their schedule, they've had 3 shutouts, and I don't care what you do, you're playing a college football team, and to get a shutout is saying something. I put some of the onus a little bit this week on the offense to be able to attack, to see how they would do that. Did you feel as if the offense would have to come out and be more special this week?
Well, I didn't know, you know, I want to run the football. We all want to have success on the ground. We want to run the clock, but we got to score points. And Mark and I have talked a lot about, you know, the successes we've had really hasn't been a lot of success when it comes to a lot of phases of our offensive football team. We run the football well at times, we throw it at times, we hadn't really put it together. And I told our staff too, and we don't need to get impatient. We needed to stay patient. We needed to, you know, run the football if we were able to and throw the football if we were able to. And I thought Luke played a really solid football game. He made some great checks at the line, actually into some runs that gave us some big first downs, and thought he protected the ball exceptionally well. And, you know, if he plays like he plays, as solid as he did, and we're able to run the football when we need to and throw the football like we did when we needed to. And our offensive football team's got a chance to be special.
A lot of people from Wingate gave Luke Lancaster a lot of praise after this game because of his poise in the pocket. Let's take a look at your first half highlights, Tusculum versus Wingate. It was another dreary day, and I think we've talked about this year, Joe Bird and I, how many times we played in the day with the lights on, and that would be the case today. Coach, the Pioneers with the Pioneer Walk through the gates, getting ready for the football game.
Yeah, you know, our kids love that Pioneer Walk, and I'm not a big fan of all that pink, I'll tell you that, but they seem to like it, so I'll let them wear it. But it was a dreary day, and they asked before the game if we wanted to turn the lights on, and you know, Joe and I agreed it didn't really matter, but we got an opportunity to play under the lights, and that's always a good thing. It looks like the legendary coach Bob Dibble there congratulating our men's golf team, and they obviously won the South Atlantic Conference Tournament last year, and congratulations to them.
Nick Forsberg was one of the key guys in that, along with Brad Hawkins, the men's tennis team, also with a conference championship from a year ago. Of course, the athletics in the spring last year was solid, thanks in large part to this man and his brother. That's Jonas Winkelmann. He's very intelligent, very smart, President's Award winner through the South Atlantic Conference. And then it was time for football as the Pioneers would come onto the field. Just some of the numbers for Wingate this year. They lead the nation in scoring defense, allowing just 5.6 points per game. They're tops in the conference in total defense as well, just 200 yards a game. That's fourth in the nation. First down defense, that's seventh in the nation. Now, I say those particular numbers because you give Mark Kolb a challenge like that, and we'll see what happens. The Pioneers get a stop on defense, so they force a punt. This is the first play from scrimmage, and this is the Kolb challenge. Oh, we're going to test you.
Got to catch his football. I know Evan Altizer there is sick at his stomach. And great call, great throw by Luke, great protection up front. We're on our own five-yard line opportunity there for a 95-yard touchdown. But here's a young man that made a difference in the day, Isaac Robinson there, breaking the tackle, moving the chains for us, giving us some great work. And I want to go here to Rodnell Krull and Evan Altizer. Just doing an unbelievable job blocking. Justin catches it and gets a first down. But those guys are just doing a great job blocking for us and doing the things that we need them to do. And here's Luke hitting Justin again. And, that combination lasted. We got a personal foul late hit on them there that gave us an automatic first, which always is helpful.
It was on third down and long, so a first down via penalty. Coach, you came into this game, said you had to win the game on first and second down. You could not get into third downs today.
That's exactly what we said. Let's win the game on first down. Let's get some positive yards. And here's Isaac making a big run again. And guys up front doing a really good job creating some seams. And Isaac being patient enough to find those seams. And, you know, here we're protecting Luke really well. We're doing a good job here. We hit Rodnell Krull. They kept calling him Rodney Krull, so he was getting a hard time on the sidelines there. But Rodnell's a freshman from down in Louisiana. And happy for him to get his hands on the football. He's sort of been a guy that has done everything we need him to do and hadn't had a chance to get his hands on the ball, but Saturday he got a few catches, so I was happy for him.
Already in this drive, Luke Lancaster attempted nearly as many passes as he did at the entire last week, but he had number 22 to give the ball to, and Isaac had this only catch of the day. This goes for 16 yards, and again, not in third downs very often, but when they were, it seems as if they were being picked up by number 22 as well.
Yeah, we had a little confusion here and thought we were going to be open and had a little confusion in the route running scheme and got it corrected so that the next time we were able to run that play, we got a touchdown. This is second down, and they do a good job containing Isaac, keeping him from getting much. And Mark goes back to that previous call, and we got a wide open guy there. And this is a great ball and even a better catch to go up and catch at its highest point and get 1 foot down the back of the end zone, touchdown, Justin Houston.
And Houston, who gets both of those, gets the touchdown before the Pioneers, would score one a bit later as well. And that would be seven on the year, seven receiving touchdowns for Justin Houston on the season. The point after was no good. It would fail. But the Pioneers, 19 plays, 93 yards, 7:53 off the clock for the Tusculum Pioneers. That was the score at the end of the first, 6-0. Wingate driving here in the second quarter, and it's first and 10 for the Pioneers. And Kyle Johnson really kept the ball a lot more than I thought he would on this day.
I'm glad we were able to have the ball in his hands and keep it out of 23's hands as much as anything, but I thought we played great. There's a young man from the lower state of South Carolina down there, and Akeem Peoples making a big play there on a receiver, but I thought we played well up front. I thought our defensive line did exceptionally well of containing the run, and here unfortunately they get us on a little trick, and we got to cover that guy obviously, but you know, all in all, I thought we played well enough to win the football game, obviously, from a defensive standpoint.
Jake Jensen with that touchdown reception. The point was good. It was 7-6. So the Pioneers come right back on the ensuing possession. Lancaster to Houston for 6, to Houston for 7 yards. And again, this is the biggest difference in that team, those guys blocking on the outside.
It's really amazing to watch it again. I mean, I don't think we give Rodnell Krull and Evan Altizer enough credit. Here's a young man from South Carolina, Ken Drummond. He can really run. He gets his hands on the ball. He stumbles a little bit. And here's a very unselfish move by Kenny Funny, getting down there and blocking for his young buddy there from South Carolina. And two South Carolina guys and getting the ball in the end zone. Happy for Ken Drummond there to score.
Ken Drummond has 3 catches for his Pioneer career. 2 have been for scores.
Sounds like we need to get it to him more than we are, doesn't it,
Brian? That's that, yeah. 3 plays, 89 yards, and 1:05 off the clock. Already on 2 drives for the Pioneers, they are equaling the amount of yards that Wingate is giving up on the season. So the Pioneers, who get the point after, make it a 13-7 game. Wingate would get the football right back on the ensuing drive as they trail in the game 13-7. Lawrence Pittman was the league's 2nd leading rusher at 136 yards per game, only behind that of Damian Baker. Didn't get many touches on the day, but you really swarmed to him when he had it.
Flying around right there, making some plays. I see DeAndre Johnson doing his part inside. Marlon Joyner probably played his best football game, and our defensive ends continue to do a good job. And here, Corky's doing a good job keeping the guy off of him. And it looks like Brent Williams, a transfer from out in California, junior college kid that's really starting to come on and getting some more playing time and getting him on the ground there. And here they throw it underneath, but we're where we need to be. Just another great play there by Keem Peoples, I think it is. Mm-hmm. No, that might be Cam Thomas. I believe Cam ran with that crosser and gets him on the ground. But one of Cam's best football games of the year as well.
The Pioneers would hold a 3-and-out and force a punt. Evan Altizer is one of the most electric punt returners. This is one of the cases where a guy hat on ball was in the perfect spot.
Yeah, just happened to put it where it needed to be put. We got to hang on to the football. A turnover is very, very sad and critical, but a turnover on special teams can truthfully get you beat. And we were fortunate that we get one back on the punt team a little while later, but Evan's got to hang on to that football there regardless, and we sure can't give him the ball on the 25-yard line.
All right, so it's 13-7, the Pioneers, who had just forced that 3-and-out but then turned the ball over. It's the first mistake of the football game via a turnover, and the Pioneers would give the Wingate Bulldogs the short field. And what we noticed on this day, if you give them the short field, they're typically going to score. And they move the ball inside the 10-yard line as Kyle Johnson, again, the numbers this year aren't necessarily there rushing-wise, or should say passing-wise for Kyle Johnson, but they came out, tried to throw it around. They go for 2nd down and goal, and then Kyle Johnson would keep it around the right end and scamper in for his 4th rushing touchdown.
Yeah, we got to do a little better job there, but of course we give him the ball on the 25-yard line. It's hard to bow your backs in that situation. We talked about, actually when we turned the ball over, I told our defense, we put you in this situation a lot in practice. Let's go out and do what we can to keep him out of the end zone. But unfortunately, they got some points there, and we go into halftime down 1 and knew it would be a 4-quarter battle. We got 2 great quarters ahead of us.
The Pioneers had some time right there after that touchdown. Would drive down, unable to score, and punt the ball away, and Wingate would run the clock out to end the half. So at the half, Wingate leads 14-13, but an interesting side note, this is the first time they've trailed all season long in this football game, and it's about to get real exciting in the second half. We'll talk about that when we return after this as you listen and watch the Frankie DeBusk Show.
Andrew Johnson Bank was founded on conservative banking principles. Over the last 30 years, they have steadily built their balance sheet and increased capital by following prudent lending principles and avoiding risky investments. In uncertain times, you can continue to count on Andrew Johnson Bank, your locally owned community bank. A strong heritage, a stronger future. Andrew Johnson Bank, member FDIC. Lewis looking, left-hander, gets rid of it, throws it deep. It's going to be picked off at the 40. At the 35, spinning is Cam Thomas, and he'll go down at the 26. But it's a turnover, and the Pioneers have the ball, leading 24-21.
This is Cam Killer Thomas, and let's get back to the game once again, Brown State.
Welcome back into the Frankie DeBusk Show. Tusculum versus Wingate University. It's the 20th meeting between these two schools, and the Pioneers trail at halftime by a score of 14-13. Last year, Coach, you trail at halftime 10-0. Kyle Dickey comes in. It's homecoming there at Wingate. Leads you back from behind with 2 second-half touchdowns to win the game 14-10. You had a defensive stand as you watched Wingate travel all the way down the field and get that. It had that same type of feel, or did it?
Well, no, I knew that it was going to be a four-quarter ball game, and every year we play them, it seems to be close, and this was, you know, just like any in the past, and I guess it was very similar to last year's contest. I didn't realize the score was 10-0 at halftime, and told our team we were tied. We got to pretend like we're tied, regardless of being, you know, down by one there, and we were getting the ball first. We need to put together a good drive. We need to be consistent, and we don't need to get impatient. We need to stay patient and go win the football game.
Well, and part of homecoming is there's a lot of alumni back, but there's a lot of former Pioneers who have returned. And this past weekend was the Sports Hall of Fame weekend. We'll talk a little bit more about that in the program. But of the three that were inducted, two of them were former Pioneers and part of the greatest football season to date in NCAA Division II. And the Pioneers went to the NCAA tournaments. As we take a look at your second half highlights, we start with two guys that were directly responsible for a lot of the success. Coach, I'm talking about Dr. Jarrell Neesmith and Corey Russell.
Two great football players there. I know Dr. Neesmith's in the white hat and Corey's there in the middle. Just two great football players that have done so much for Tusculum College, and they did a great job at their acceptance speech Saturday morning, and just proud of those two guys. They mean so much to us, and we love them as people, and they were great when they were here, and just really taking the legacy to the next level.
Jarrell, as also it was known during the whole induction ceremony for the Hall of Fame, also announced to his mother-in-law and his mom that he and his wife were expecting their first child in March, so they were extremely excited about that, and Jarrell very excited. We were excited when he was here because he was one of the most prolific tight ends to ever play the game as far as receiving yards for a tight end, and joked with him about not being very fast, and I should also emphasize that he had some still pretty good speed, but he also was very strong. As far as academics are concerned, the President's Award winner for two consecutive years for the Pioneers, it was just one of those things that, you know, doesn't always happen. And as an academic All-American and an All-American for his accolades on the field. And there's Corey Russell, before pre-Bo Cordell, I guess you could say, had some records that I didn't ever think would be broken. 11,000 total yards and passing yards. And just a guy that didn't really even look like he should be even playing quarterback.
He was an amazing player. We were joking. He said he weighed 178 pounds after the season was over his senior year. I was comparing him a little bit to Luke now, and I said, Luke probably weighs 180, 190. He said, Coach, I weighed 178 to end of my senior year. So obviously Luke's put on a little more weight than Corey, but Corey was a great football player and probably was a better leader of our football team than he was even a player. Just had that natural grit. He obviously comes from a good family, and his mom and dad were at the induction ceremony, and just he just has what it takes. He's got that it factor, and he's now the head coach of his former high school up there in Cumberland Gap, and just two good quality people.
Josh Wolf is the other member, and we'll talk about him coming up. Pioneers would have the ball to start the second half. They would drive it out near midfield, some penalties. I thought that was the play of the game.
Probably was.
I think Hunter saving that ball from going over, and then a little fortune for the Pioneers.
Probably was. Hits them. We get on it. Just to, actually our – our punter is obviously an athlete. Hunter Cantrell there goes up and bats the ball back down to him. And if that ball goes over his head, it's probably changes momentum for them. And they end up getting it inside our own territory. But instead, we get lucky here. The ball hits them in the foot. We end up coming up with a huge turnover. I don't know that we do what we need to offensively on this drive, but we still get the ball in that territory.
Ken Drummond with that fumble recovery, as it just did, hit the foot of a gunner for the Wingate Bulldogs. So the Pioneers do take over first and 10 with the short field. And Luke Lancaster looking for some help. And really fortunate there is Justin Houston was covered up.
Yeah, we lucky we didn't get one block there and didn't do what we needed to do offensively. Send our kicker out here, and, you know, we're not kicking as well as we need to right now. Those have been just sort of gimmies from in the first four or five ball games. We got to get back to that. But we got to do a little bit better job offensively. We don't need to send our field goal unit out there once we get the ball in that situation. But fortunately, playing good enough defensively, there's Cam Thomas making something happen, and you see seven or eight, I guess I got to call them gray jerseys instead of black jerseys, yeah, flying to the football.
Quez Gaines, another big game. He had nine tackles. DeAndre Johnson with seven. Akeem Peoples, Lakeith Brown, Brandon Bartlett each with six. Again, the conference's second leading rusher, Lawrence Pittman, was held to just 82 yards. Kyle Johnson ran for 26 on the day, but he was running for his life. He was 15 of 22, 129 yards. He's only thrown one interception this year. It was not in this game. And he, Deshae Williams will come around the end. And this is one of the very few times he's been sacked on the year, too.
Yeah, great job here by Deshae, one of our seniors from down in Mississippi. Happy for him to have some success. He played well Saturday, too, but gets a big sack there. There's Marlon Joyner and big Jatu Booker from Austin East, a freshman there, put some pressure on him. And Emmanuel Bumbley played well. Emmanuel's one of our other seniors from over in the North Carolina area. Just proud of those guys, the way they played up front.
So it remains 14-13 as Wingate would punt the ball away. And this is the drive that Isaac Robinson returns. He had missed the entire second quarter due to a little injury, and that then came back this particular drive. Just an unfortunate play there. That looked like it could have gone for big yards. So Lancaster comes right back, finds Isaac Robinson once again for yet another catch.
Biggest thing he does here, he catches the ball well, but he makes that first guy miss, breaks the tackle. Hadn't been doing that a lot until the last couple ball games, so hopefully he's starting to get into the groove of things and get recovered from not being able to play last year due to injury, and he's really starting to get his motor running. We're doing some really good things. And here Kenny Funny has got to hang on to the football. We're doing our part blocking downfield, and we just don't just carrying that ball like a bread basket there. We got to do a little better job. It's very frustrating for Kenny, very frustrating for us, but he's one of our senior leaders that knows we got to hang on to the football.
The Pioneers, you can tell, moving and feeling good about themselves. But again, miscues, missed field goal and now a fumble. But you hold them to, once again, another punt. And I'm thinking it's Newberry all over again, especially when this punt just dies.
I couldn't believe that. That thing hits about the 4 and dies at the 2. We're doing exactly what we're supposed to do back there. Keem's supposed to let it fall and run in the end zone. And we get it back there, but we have some little different results. And this is just a great throw. This is great for Evan to regroup after he's not done some things like he would like to, and that's a big-time catch. Wow, big-time catch there. Big 40-yard gain, get us out of the backed up where we were and just moving the chains.
That's my second play of the game because it's hard telling. It's first down, and Isaac Robinson had no gain. It was his only rush of the day that he was given minus yards, and then Altizer, he just kept feeding him. He goes for 12. Altizer later will go for 10 yards.
Great job blocking downfield by Justin Houston. Very unselfish. There he is, giving it all he's got. Evan giving it all he's got, moving the chains, kind of hanging on the ball again. I know he had him, but they're fighting to get it loose there, and we just got to keep hanging on. Hand it back to Isaac. He's breaking tackles and getting 6 and 7. I think he averaged 7 yards a carry on the day, which is just unbelievable.
And he's running he's a different runner right now. I think 250 yards really helped his confidence.
Yeah, he does. He has a lot of confidence. Our kids up front have confidence, and anything you do, especially sports-related, if you can start believing in it, you're going to have some more success. And he's doing what we need him to do right now for sure.
I like what he said after the game. You know, it's not that I'm hitting the hole harder. It's that I'm more patient and seeing. And this is what you see with his vision and being patient. And then he just runs to some daylight, and it just, again, just a different. I've slowed it down. It doesn't really give you an idea to see the speed because he has it going into the secondary.
Great job up front. He sees a little crease, takes it backside, runs it for a 16-yard touchdown. We needed some good things to happen, and Isaac's obviously playing well and is helping that cause.
So the Pioneers, who would go for 2 and fail on the 2-point conversion, would lead by a score of 19-14. Got some Luke Manning fans. Just wanted to point that out. That were in the
Of our freshman players there.
So they were on him. So this is the Wingate Bulldogs. Really one of their better drives as we have moved into the fourth quarter. Longest play of the day was on this drive. It was on 3rd down and 4, and Fuller made a guy miss, and then he ran for 24 yards to really set up this drive. 1st and 10, Pittman for 8. Then he loses 2 yards, and then a pass attempt for Barry knocked away by Cameron Thomas with some outstanding coverage, settling for a field goal.
Great job by our defensive football team. That's fine. They put a long drive together, but we held them to 3, and loved it for them not to score, but 3's obviously better than 6, and Cam made a big play there on that slant.
So it's 19-17. It was 14 plays, 72 yards. And you keep going to Kenny Funny. 1 for 7 yards on 3rd down and 6, then for 4 yards on 1st down and 10. Then Rodnell Cruel gets involved, and again, you're winning the battle on 1st and 2nd down.
Just really executing is what we're doing. We're asking our receivers to block, our receivers to catch, asking Luke to make the right read, whether we need to hand it off or flip it out there on a little screen. And they were giving it to us, and I thought, again, I go back to what I mentioned earlier, I thought Mark Kolb did a really fine job of making some great calls and giving the ball to that man right there, letting him run it like he's run it. Great execution by Isaac. Great job up front. Big first down.
And again, Isaac had some family in attendance, a brother, I think, who was serving this country, and he was able to see this wonderful performance. 195 yards on the day for Isaac Robinson, 28 carries with 2 touchdowns. Takes the ball down to the 2, and this is that unselfish part. I asked him about this. Why didn't they let you punch it in? Well, it was too evident. Justin Houston is just one-on-one, basically, and he's just too wide open.
Great job here by Jordan Barnes making that little block. He didn't do a whole lot, but he freeze him up enough, and Luke makes a good throw, Justin, good catch, he walks in the end zone. You know, we can't be selfish as an offensive football team. We're spreading it around, giving everybody a little bit of the wealth. We just got to find a way to score.
9 plays, 66 yards, 3:40 off the clock, a lot of it on the ground from Isaac Robinson, of runs of 26 yards, runs of 16 yards on the day, part of that 195-yard total. That just really does more than enough to pump up the defense, who probably had their most complete game of the day as Wingate comes out. It's been the three-and-out issue. We haven't gotten people off the field, but on this particular drive, you really swarm up.
Well, look at us. Yeah, Brian, there's 9 guys there running to the football. They're feeling it. It's back to that confidence thing. I didn't mean to interrupt you there, but our kids are getting excited. I'm getting excited watching it again. We got a lot of gray jerseys running to the ball, flying around, believing in what we're doing, getting off blocks, making plays, hitting them like we're supposed to, getting them on the ground. Emmanuel Bumbley there and Derez Ben making a big play, you know, putting them in long yardage, giving us a chance, and just really, really happy with our effort. And here Cam's doing a great job covering number three. He was number three's a really good player for them, a good receiver, but Cam did a great job hitting him on all day. That's why he'll be one of our defensive players of the week.
A Pioneer lead of 26-17 after forcing a three and out, and then you have still about 6 minutes to play in this football game. And, Coach, this is the biggest difference I see in this team. You give it to Robinson, it's second down and 4. He goes for 14. You give it to him again, he takes it inside the 5, and you take a knee and kill the last 6 minutes of the game.
Very easily could have scored again there, but obviously they weren't calling timeouts. I'm not real sure why they didn't care at that point in time, but get us a big win. Huge homecoming win for our Board of Trustees and all the alumni that are back. You see how excited our players are. And, hey, there's me and my little man. That's Ty right there. I love having him with me after a big win like that. And just a great way to go out, for a nice home, nice homecoming victory for everybody associated.
It's the Pioneer victory, and it's evening their record, too, at 3-3 on the season. And they go even in the South Atlantic Conference as well at 2-2. It is their second consecutive win against the Wingate Bulldogs as well. And for Coach Joe Reich, I'm sure they came in, thought they had probably a good plan. I was a little surprised to see them try to spread it out and spread your defense out a little bit instead of hand it off to Pittman as much. That's what seems to have worked. Is it a case of maybe coaches sometimes out-coaching themselves?
I made that comment several times to our staff on Saturday, so maybe they were. I don't know. But I thought we had a good plan to try to stop the run, and maybe they saw we had more in the box than they thought they could block and went to throwing the ball. And we always like to see that. Just thought we did a good job of running the football when we had to and stopping the run when we had to. I think if we can do those two things and be a little bit more consistent in the special teams game, we got a chance to be pretty good.
It was a homecoming win for the Pioneers as they knock off Wingate by a final of 26-17, put them right back into the thick of things in the South Atlantic Conference standings. We'll talk a little bit more about that later. But coming up, we have a couple of interviews with a couple of our players of the game as well. We'll meet our players of the week as picked by the coaches of Tusculum College, and we will wrap it up as well as we return right after this. A homecoming win for the Pioneers, 26-17 over the Wingate Bulldogs. Back with more of the Frankie DeBusk Show.
Your Greenville Light and Power System, an electrical distributor of TVA, serving Greenville and Greene County since 1945. Your Greenville Light and Power is dedicated to excellence in service and reliability. Visit online at glps.net. Sodexo, a world leader in food and facilities management services. Sodexo proudly serves Tusculum College and supports Pioneer football. Sodexo, making every day a better day.
Welcome back to the Frankie DeBusk Show. Once again, the voice of the Pioneers, Ryan Stayton.
Pioneers knock off the Wingate Bulldogs for homecoming by a final score of 26-17. It was the 20th meeting between the two schools, and now Wingate has a slimmer 12-9 edge against Tusculum. But the Pioneers have won the last two prior going into that game. Wingate had won 5 of the last 7. It's time for our Applebee's interviews, our Applebee's player profile. I hadn't had a chance to catch up with a couple of guys after the game, but we did on this particular day. Somewhat of a homecoming of sorts for Isaac Robinson, as his brother was in after serving this great country. Have a chance to watch his brother play football as well. And DeAndre Johnson, who has been outstanding on the defensive line. They are our Applebee's player profile.
Our Applebee's player profile after the game. The Pioneers knock off the Wingate Bulldogs, joined by DeAndre Johnson and Isaac Robinson. DeAndre, seven tackles today, taking on an offense that came in rush-oriented. We knew they could pass it. Did you guys have to worry about them throwing the ball? And that's how they lined up to start the football game. Did that throw a wrinkle in your plan?
Not really. We have the best DBs in the set, you know, so we already knew they were going to take care of our business. The front seven, we just had to take care of our business. Everything went to key perfection.
All right, it's a running back that we know was really good. He finishes with 82 yards in the game. He rushes for 136 per game. You guys held him under 100. What does that mean about this defense right now?
Lineman football, you know. Everybody had their keys, their jobs. Everybody come out here, do their own job, and everything be successful.
All right, Kyle Johnson hurt us, the quarterback seven, running the football just a little bit. Were you surprised he ran as much as he did today?
Yeah, but, I mean, we got to be happy his pressure getting to him. So, you know, he can get those couple yards. As long as he don't throw it down the field, we're good.
He didn't throw it down the field very much today. Is that by design, by putting pressure on him?
Yeah, you know, everything happened for a reason. So, we just came out here. It's homecoming. We knew what we had to do. It's no more losses.
All right, look, that's two in a row now for this Pioneer team and this defense. We're going to talk with this guy over here because, you know, he's running the football so effectively. But how confident are you guys playing on defense right now?
We're very confident. You know, we got Isaac Robinson. He's a horse running the ball. So once he gets his rhythm, no one can really stop him. You know, defense, we just got to come out here, do our assignment, you know, and everything go in.
All right, congratulations, DeAndre. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
DeAndre Johnson. This is Isaac Robinson, runs for 196, 21 carries. Last week it was 250, a new school record, single game record. We talked a little bit about that. You told me last week, look, you know, I think what I need to do is slow myself down. Did you slow yourself down today?
Yeah, just slow myself going to the line of scrimmage until the play developed. Then when I see it, I hit it, you know, so.
It doesn't make a lot of sense to a radio guy. Slow yourself down. You want to go faster. But I think the vision that you had today was exceptional. And right. I think without all the rain in your eyes from a week ago against Brevard, you missed some time. What was that like? What was that about? And why were you out so long?
Out so long for – I had a little knee scare earlier. But, you know, it was just a little tweak, you know. I got back in and did what I had to do.
All right, look, it's a defense that was number one in the nation in total offense. You put 500 up on them today, and it was balanced. How confident is this offense right now?
Oh, very confident. We got, like I said, we got tools all around the field. You know, if they stop in the running game, then boom, we hit them on the screen or we hit them down the field. We got threats all over the field. So it's like really, you know, where you're going to stop us at? You gotta cover all your ends when you're playing us as an offense. So, you know, we're very confident.
All right, you've got – the running play maybe of the game from 16 yards away, you kind of get that lead, that little bit of a buffer there in the third quarter. You guys finally broke through. Did you feel as if the game was won at that moment right there in the third quarter?
No, I don't ever feel like the game won until I see, you know, zero on the clock. You know, you can't ever think about that. But at the end of the day, I felt like we had our momentum. We kept on doing what we had to do. Then we would have came out on top.
All right, give me your opinion. The number one defense in the country, is that what you guys faced today?
Yep. I mean, you know, ain't no telling. We still got some more other teams to play. It's all about alignment and assignment. You know, it could be other defense that match up better with us, you know, in the future, you know. But at the end of the day, like I said, we got too many threats on the offense for us to be held back.
Think about it. 10 points is what separates you guys in conference play from being unbeaten in the league. Is that frustrating for you? Or do you guys feel as if we just move on, we put that behind us, and now we attack the rest of the schedule?
I mean, I feel like we treat it as a learning experience. Of course, it's things at the end of time. At the end of the day, you know, it's you know, we can't forget about it as much as we want to. But at the end of the day, we got to learn from it and know that we could have been undefeated in the sack right now. We need to keep on pushing and do what we got to do to remain, you know, undefeated throughout this point, you know, from in sack play.
Congratulations. Outstanding game.
All right. Thank you.
That's Isaac Robinson. And those two, DeAndre Johnson, Isaac Robinson, our Applebee's player profile.
It's time for our players of the week. And we'll start on offense with the guy you just heard from, Isaac Robinson, a sophomore out of Palmyra, Virginia, from Monticello High School. Again, 28 carries, the ninth best rushing day for a Pioneer with 195 yards with the touchdown. He is now already the fifth best rusher in South Atlantic Conference this year, averaging 108 yards per game. And folks, just two games ago, he had just 79 yards on the season. Total, last two games, he's nearing 500 yards. Justin Houston is our other offensive player of the week, the senior from Cleveland, Tennessee, the All-American out of Bradley Central High School. He finishes with 8 receptions, 44 yards, and 2 touchdowns. Talked in our open about Justin Houston and Kenny Funny being the duo that leads the nation now in receptions for a career. And we talked about who they passed. One of them was Rashad Carter. Well, Justin Houston now needs just 116 yards receiving to surpass the record held by Rashad Carter for first all time. Already the conference's, or I should say the school's, record holder for receptions in a career. Our defensive players of the week, Cameron Thomas, the junior from Nicholasville, Kentucky, out of East Jessamine High School. He finished with 5 tackles, 2 pass breakups on the day. He is first in the conference in not only interceptions, but now also pass breakups. Our other defensive player of the week is a senior from Hanahan, South Carolina, from Hanahan High School. He's Iram Aiken. He finishes with 5 tackles on the day as well. Our special teams didn't perform up to par, but there was one who succeeded and was very good on this day. Jordan Barnes, the redshirt freshman out of Goose Creek, South Carolina, from Goose Creek High School. Might not be a stat sheet stuffer, but he was outstanding with 1 tackle and was special in covering punts and kickoffs. We've molded over just a little bit to try to figure out what our call of the game. It's not necessarily the play of the game. However, we feel the next plays very well have been our plays of the game. We'll put them in a row for you. Number one, the save on the high snap for Hunter Cantrell. Thought it may have been the actual play of the game and saving momentum. It led to the Pioneers getting a turnover deep inside their own territory. It was a pass from Luke Lancaster, all or nothing, and an over-the-shoulder basket catch that was better than that of a guy named Mantle or Robinson who could have ever done in the baseball outfield to Evan Altizer. Then, the play that ended the game, and it was the back-breaking run that nearly put Isaac Robinson over 200 yards for a second consecutive week. It was the game-breaker and the play that's just for the Wingate Bulldogs said, we don't need to take any more timeouts. Those for your calls of the game.
A high snap. Cantrell comes down with it, and he does well. It'll be an end-over-end kick. It actually does well to stay away from a Wingate Bulldog. They're going to say it was tipped by a Wingate Bulldog, and the Pioneers have recovered it. Lancaster to pass. He's looking deep for Altizer, who's behind the defense. Over-the-shoulder grab is made at the 38-yard line. That time, Evan Altizer with a phenomenal catch goes out of bounds at the 42, a gain of 40. Lancaster hands it off. This will be Robinson up the middle. 10, 5 to the 4, first and goal, and that should be ball game. I don't think that Joe Reich will take another timeout again.
It's time now for your post-game wrap-up. On the day, the number one defense in not allowing first downs. I watched the Pioneers pick up 29 first downs on the day, while Wingate picked up only 15. Tusculum rushed for 243 yards as a team, limiting Wingate to 119. Tusculum throws for 268 on the day, limiting Wingate to 129. Tusculum ran 75 plays for 511 yards, while Wingate ran 58 plays for 248 yards on the day. Tusculum had more time of possession, 32 minutes and 13 seconds to Wingate's 27-47, and Tusculum was great on third downs, 7 of 11. Wingate only allowed 29% on the year, while Wingate was 5 of 14. In the red zone, Wingate was 3 for 3, while the Pioneers finished 3 for 4 on the day. It was also Tusculum's Hall of Fame induction, and there were 3 guys that were inducted into the Sports Hall of Fame on this particular day. 2 of them were football players, and 1 of them was a baseball player. We love Josh Wolf. He's a gritty, gutty performer, but we also have to pay tribute to our 2 football players. That's where we'll start. And you saw them at halftime. You saw them in the show a little bit, but let's talk a little bit more about Dr. Jarrell Neesmith. He would be the first inductee on the day. He's the first guy that we'll talk about. On the field, he was a 2-time All-Conference selection first-teamer, where he amassed 1,670 career receiving yards, the 10th most in school history for a tight end. It's the most ever. His 158 career receptions, 8th in the record books, and his 12 career touchdowns are 10th. In 2009, he led the league in receiving yards, averaging 67.8 yards per contest for a tight end, posted 56 catches for 678 yards and 3 touchdowns. He was named All-Region First Team for a second straight year and was selected to the Associated Press All-America team. He even participated in the Division II All-Star Game in Kingsville, Texas. Out of Russellville, Alabama, Jarrell was named the South Atlantic Conference Scholar Athlete on 3 occasions, becoming the first time 3 recipient of the award in conference history. Also a 2-time recipient of the conference's President's Award, becoming the first conference football player in history of the award to earn that conference's most prestigious honor. And he did that not on one, but 2 occasions. He was also a 2-time Southeast Region representative for the Division II Conference Commissioner Scholar Athlete Award and was a national semifinalist for the American Football Coaches Association Good Works team. The accolades go on and on and on, but the best that Dr. Jarrell Neesmith will be known for is the fact that he's about to become a daddy in March with he and his wife, Brittany. Congratulations to Dr. Neesmith. Our other was Corey Russell. And do we need to say more? He accounted for one of the best playing careers ever by a Tusculum quarterback. He led Tusculum to 3 straight winning seasons as a starter, including the 2008 campaign, in which the Pioneers claimed the conference championship and made their first ever trip to the playoffs. During his career, he guided the Pioneers to 22 victories as a starter, including a 21-14 record in his final 3 seasons combined. His 11,315 career total offensive yards are the second most in school history, 3rd in the conference record book, and 27th in NCAA history. He passed for 9,887 yards while rushing for 1,428 yards, the 5th most in program history and the most by a Tusculum quarterback. Russell accounted for 103 career touchdowns, 82 passing, and 21 rushing for the 2nd most in school history and the 3rd most in conference history. He was named the 2008 South Atlantic Conference Offensive Player of the Year, Region Player of the Year, and his name is peppered throughout the Tusculum, SAC, and NCAA record books. He established 15 Tusculum records in 08, including a pair of Division II best, recorded 300 or more total offensive yards on 11 occasions. He was also selected to play in the All-Star Game, and for his efforts in 2008, he was named the Conference Male Athlete of the Year and the Tusculum Male Athlete of the Year as well. And oh, by the way, he was a Harlan Hill Trophy finalist, which recognizes the Division II National Player of the Year. He finished 6th in that. Corey is currently the head coach at Cumberland Gap High School, just up the road here from Tusculum College. Not doing so well, but Corey was a wrestler. He was a winner, and he's going to turn that program into a winner as well. Another guy that is definitely a winner and the 3rd member of the new Hall of Fame class for 2015, that was Josh Wolf. Wolf was inducted because he still owns 11 school records and is ranked in the top 10 in 19 statistical categories. During his career, he led the Pioneers to a 151-76 and 1 record. That 1 tie came against Armstrong Atlantic because they don't have lights, which included 2 conference championships, 2 trips to the NCAA tournament, and they won the 2005 SAC tournament title. He currently holds school records for hits, 782 at bats, scored runs, stolen bases. He played in 211 games with 205 starts. For his career, he boasted a .335 batting average, 114 runs batted in, and a .399 on-base percentage. He recorded 20 doubles, each in back-to-back campaigns in 2005 and 2006. Josh Wolf was one of the best all-time in school history. And if you don't believe me, just ask his teammates and what they felt of him. Aaron Fry, one of his teammates, was unable to be at the ceremony, but Aaron has started the annual scholarship at Tusculum that will be named in Josh's honor. It will be called the Josh Wolf 06 Annual Baseball Scholarship, which will provide financial support for able and deserving students enrolled at Tusculum who participate in baseball. These 3 guys are important to me because I was able to broadcast their entire career. Got a chance to meet them on a personal level and talk with them about a lot of things outside of their sport, of their interest. And then to see them come back to campus knowing that they will be all they can be for Tusculum for the rest of their life. They didn't necessarily want to be Division II athletes. They wanted to be on that big stage, but they realized when they got here where they were. It's home. And they will be ambassadors for Tusculum College for the rest of their life, inducted into the Sports Hall of Fame. We spent enough time talking about guys. Let's bring another guy in who likes to talk, Coach Debusk, as we talk about next week's game with North Greenville. The Pioneers victorious on homecoming against Wingate. Don't forget, this is a football show, by a final score of 26 217. We're back right after this.
Andrew Johnson Bank was founded on conservative banking principles. Over the last 30 years, they have steadily built their balance sheet and increased capital by following prudent lending principles and avoiding risky investments. In uncertain times, you can continue to count on Andrew Johnson Bank, your locally owned community bank. A strong heritage, a stronger future. Andrew Johnson Bank, member FDIC. Creekside Market has three locations in Southern Greene County to serve. So while you're traveling to or from any game, stop by and pick up a Hunt Brothers pizza for those football Friday nights or Saturday afternoons. Creekside Market, just off the 107, locations on the Asheville Highway, Camp Creek, and the Irwin Highway. Creekside Markets in Greene County. This is going to be Robinson again. He'll go right up the middle again at the 30. Robinson 25-20. Robinson 15 and taken out of bounds by Lunsford at the 11-yard line. A first and 10 by the Pioneers.
This is Isaac Robinson. You watch the highlights of Pioneer football and the Frankie Debusk Show.
And welcome back into the Frankie Debusk Show. Tusculum knocking off Wingate for homecoming. And now the brutal part of this schedule continues with 4 of 5 on the road. The next 2 weeks on the road, but out of conference. And head scratchers. I think that's the easiest way to put it. What are we going to face when we travel to Tigerville to take on a North Greenville team that's beating this team real bad, but not this team real bad, and then getting beat by this team? So we're not real sure, but what we do know, our team, I think, playing at a very high level.
We are. If we can just keep playing with some confidence, Brian, and keep believing in what we're doing, stay healthy, we will obviously watch, evaluate. We've already seen North Greenville and know they're a good football team, but we'll have to evaluate what they're doing and try to get a good plan together. I know Jeff Farrington, their head coach, is a really good guy, and he'll have them ready to play, and hopefully the head coach of Tusculum College will have his bunch ready to play. I know right now we're feeling really good about things, but even like I told him at halftime in our Wingate game, you know, we're loose, we were feeling good, but I said stop for 1 minute and think if we don't play the next two quarters like we're supposed to, how that bad taste is going to be in our mouth. Well, we're going into Tigerville over in North Greenville to see a good football team. They've put it on some very good football teams that's come rolling in there, and we've got to play a little bit better in certain phases. We got to keep being consistent in some other phases, and we got to go do our part and try to find a way to win.
Congratulations. Best of luck.
Thank you.
Pioneer coach Frankie DeVos, Tusculum versus North Greenville coming up this week, and again, the next two on the road in the state of South Carolina. It will be North Greenville this week and Limestone the following week, two non-conference games as the Pioneers look to build momentum toward the end of the season. Many thanks, as always, to all of those who are involved and the help and the assistance from the Sports Information Department from Wingate University and the Sports Information Department from Tusculum, Mr. Dom Donnelly, and J.D. J.D., we wish you the very best in your new job as you head home to Campbell University, home of the Camels. So we wish you the best. We're not going to root for you a whole lot, even though they have some orange, I think, in their school colors. Many thanks, as always, to Luke Manning for the job that he has been able to do and give us some great pictures of the game, as always. Join us for the Pioneer Sports Network for Tusculum versus North Greenville. It will be a 2:30 kickoff. You may have heard me in the broadcast on the radio say a 1:30 kickoff. I was way off on the numbers. We'll start our coverage at 1:30 on the Pioneer Sports Network, AM 1450 WSMG here in Greenville and worldwide through TusculumPioneers.com. Our kickoff will be at 2:30. For Nathan Humbert, for Coach Frankie DeBusk, I'm Brian Stayton. And until next week, go Pioneers.
This has been the Frankie DeBusk Show with head coach Frankie DeBusk, featuring coaches' interviews, player spotlights, highlights, and statistical breakdowns.
Presented by your Greenville Light and Power System, serving Greenville and Greene County since 1945. Andrew Johnson Bank, a strong heritage, a stronger future. Home-owned and operated with locations in Johnson City, Jonesboro, Morristown, Cleveland, and Greenville. Sodexo, a world leader in food and facilities management services. Sodexo, making every day a better day. Creekside Markets, don't pass by, stop by, with three locations in Greene County. Special consideration from Comcast Cable through Xfinity.